Perfect.
Good morning and Merry Christmas to you. Welcome to you, those gathered here in this space and those gathered online. We welcome you to this Christmas Day service and celebration. It is a joy to gather together. It is a privilege to be able to celebrate Christ's birth with those we love, whether here or far away, whether people are traveling or staying at home, it is good to worship together. We do want to remember folks who are on the road today, those that are at a distance. We want to remember those who are remembering loved ones who have passed. We want to remember those who are celebrating new birth, even as we celebrate the birth of Christ. So however you have arrived this morning, welcome and allow yourself to enter fully into worship today. We want to note a couple of announcements this morning. I'll note some of these on the wall, and if maybe Jeff, if you can come forward to bring the mic for announcements. So we have the annual prayer walk will be on Sunday, January 8th during the Sunday school hour. Anyone who wants to participate is welcome to. We will travel across the length of the building, praying for different locations, spaces, and ministries that will happen and take place in the coming year. Just a reminder that if there are delays and cancellations, we'll announce those through the KCRG site, on TV as well, Facebook, and through the One Call phone service. Just wanted to also remind folks that One Call is a way to receive messages via call or text. To opt in, you can text ALERT in all caps to 22300. And if you need to update your phone contact information, please contact the office. Chow meal on Wednesday, January 4th is coming up soon. We'll eat at 6 o'clock and then we'll do the takeaway hunger night to follow. Donations and volunteers are needed for that activity. And we're excited. We want to continue to highlight that Hillcrest Academy is opening up with a sixth grade class next year. And the middle school information night is going to be on Monday, January 23rd at 6:30 p.m. at Hillcrest. If you know of someone who is entering into the sixth grade next year, and please invite their family to check out the Hillcrest Middle School. Are there other announcements? Please raise your hand and Jeff will bring you the mic this morning.
This is Karen Harvey, and I just want to thank those of you that sorted and donated some of those wonderful, really beautiful used Christmas decorations, ornaments. Bethel had a really wonderful day of different activities, including the concert, of bake sale, and other venues. And they were able to raise enough money to pay pretty much for 1 month's mortgage. And we're just very excited about that. So many thanks for the ways you showed your love and support to Bethel.
This is Warren Yoder, and it's not in the bulletin, but we'll plan to have choir rehearsal this coming Wednesday night at 7 p.m. That'll be in the church choir room. We'll be practicing a few songs for Epiphany Sunday, and then also that'll be it.
If there's no one else in the sanctuary, we'll offer an opportunity for folks online to share an announcement.
Join us for the call to worship. You will read the people part with Lucas. Sing and shout. How great is our God! The heavens praise your name. The earth proclaims your glory.
How beautiful are the feet on the mountain and those who bring good news.
Great is your peace, and great are your promises.
Your good news brings comfort to my soul, and my heart in song cries out.
Sing Alleluia.
Our God reigns.
Join me in prayer. Loving Father, help us remember the birth of Jesus, that we may share in the song of the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and worship of the wise men. Close the door of hate and open the door of love all over the world. Let kindness come with every gift and good desires with every greeting. Deliver us from evil by the blessing which Christ brings, and teach us to be merry with clear hearts. May the Christmas morning make us happy to be thy children, and Christmas evening bring us to our beds with grateful thoughts, forgiving and forgiven, for Jesus' sake. Amen.
This morning we light the Christ candle. Join me in voices together, 267. What child is this? Today on a glad note, joy to the world, and let's all stand for that. And it's 240 in the worship book. 240. Mm-hmm.
Shall see stay.
Friends Rejoice, 261.
Now it's time for the dedications of gifts and offerings. There are many ways to give online and in person. Would you bow your heads with me? Holy One, as we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, we seek to honor you with these monetary gifts. We know that everything in this world is a gift from you, O God, so we humbly return a generous portion of these gifts to you. Amen.
Good morning, you guys. We have some new friends up here today. Who can quickly tell them who's going to come and talk to us? Can anyone tell them what's going on? Mr. Pricino? Mr. Pickles. Who is Mr. Pickles? Do you know who Mr. Pickles is? A sheep. Who's the shepherd? Amos. Shepherd Amos. Let's see if he's here today.
Oh, Mr. Pickles. Now, where's that sheep gotten off to today? I tell you what, I lose that sheep like Jerry and Lou lose their cell phone. Where is he now? Where is he? Where is he? Have you guys seen Mr. Pickles? You haven't seen him. What about you over there, young man? Yes? No? Yes? What about you, young lady? Have you seen Mr. Pickles anywhere? Have you? Where on earth could that Mr. Pickles be? What about you, little sheep here? Have any of you seen Mr. Pickles anywhere? Where is he? Anyone seen him? Where is he? Oh! Well, how did he get... Oh, my goodness, that Mr. Pickles. I tell you what. Yeah, he was on my back, always playing games on me. Hard to keep up with him. Okay. All right, back in your pen. Hopefully that's the last time for that. Oh, maybe so. Well, I'm very glad you're all here today. Today is the day I've been waiting for. I've been patiently waiting to tell you all a very special story that changed my life forever. It comes straight from the Bible, so I want to make sure I get it right. So you see, we shepherds were living out in the fields near Bethlehem, watching over our sheep at night, and an angel of the Lord appeared to us, and the glory of the Lord was shining all around us, and we were terrified. But the angel said to us, "Don't be afraid. I bring you great news of great joy for everyone. Today, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be your sign. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a feed trough." Then more angels appeared, all praising God and saying, "Glory to God in heaven, and on earth peace to those whom favor rests." That's right. When the angels went back to heaven, we said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see firsthand this, what this is all about, these things the Lord has told us." So we hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who really was lying in a feed trough. When we had seen him, we spread the word that the angel had told us about this child, and everyone who heard it was amazed. We returned to our pastures, glorifying and praising God for all the things we had heard and seen, which was exactly what we had been told by the angels. Now, have you ever heard a story like that? How amazing! I will never forget it. I was just a kid, nobody special. As shepherds, we were mostly left out, poor and uneducated. But we could all see this would change our lives forever. Even my brother Micah had tears running down his face. Can you imagine what it was like to have angels, angels, come to us? The Messiah, Savior of the world, was born, and we were some of the first people to go and see him. To this day, I will tell you, who will listen, do not be afraid. I have great news for you. We aren't on our own anymore. Our Savior has come. Can you say that with me? Our Savior has come. Our Savior has come. Our Savior has come. The Messiah, Savior of the world. That's right. Now, should we pray? All right, let's all bow our heads. Lord Jesus, thank you for this wonderful day. We are full of joy that you came to be one of us. Thank you so much. In your name we pray. Amen. Now, before I let you go back, should we put our last stone in the wall? Now, what do you think today's stone says? I think it's the most special one we have. This one says, Jesus. That's right. Now, should we see if it fits? I hope it does. There. That should keep Mr. Pickles in now, shouldn't it? Now, before I let you go back, I've got something for you. Oh, I know, it's not normal sheep feed. I've got treats. You can all come and get some now.
Choir would come forward. We'll sing a couple of songs. We sang for a Christmas Eve program last night, and a number of people mentioned Wednesday night. We just might as well sing on Christmas morning as well, so here we are. We'll sing two songs, "Oh How Joyfully" and "Birthday of a King."
This morning's scripture comes from the book of John, chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. The Word became flesh. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overtake it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light, the true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Amen. So it is good to be worshiping with you this morning. And this is a special time of year. And although it is a special time of year, I think sometimes in our Christian tradition, we get a little antsy. We get a little ahead of ourselves. We don't like to wait for almost anything. Even as we celebrate major church calendar moments like Christmas morning, we sometimes want to jump ahead or to anticipate the next one. And I wonder sometimes if this is maybe more of a symptom of within our culture, especially in a place, now maybe this has never happened to you, but where you are waiting for your meal at the drive-through window, and it takes more than a couple of minutes, and the carload that you are with begins to question reality. There's collective speculation that ensues on whose meal is it, whose order was it, the outlier that is making the Culver's order take so long that the employees couldn't fill it. And then decisions are made on whether or not someone needs to go in and check on the order, and straws are drawn on who will be the next one to make sure that the staff hurry it along. After all, we have places to go and things to do. When everything comes to us in an instant in our society, how do we stay fully present in the moment? How do we stay fully present this Christmas morning? Some of you may receive the meditations that come from the priest Richard Rohr. He has this daily meditation that he gives in via email. And Rohr often offers a brief reflection on a particular theme for the week. Now, he doesn't always write the reflection himself. Sometimes he draws upon other writers or authors, theologians, etc. And in one particular post this week, Rohr quoted the late Rachel Held Evans. Now, Evans was a mother of two who frequently wrote articles for all sorts of news outlets and spoke at many conferences and conventions, including the Mennonite Church USA Youth Convention in Orlando back in 2017. Evans reflected this week, or the writing that was quoted, reflected on the fact that she owed her Christianity, she said, quote, to a teenage girl living in an occupied Palestine at one of the most dangerous moments in history, who said yes, yes to God, yes to a wholehearted call she could not possibly understand, yes to vulnerability in the face of societal judgment, yes to a vision for herself and her little boy of a mission that would bring down rulers and lift up the humble, that would turn away the rich and fill the hungry with good things, that would scatter the proud and gather the lowly. Yes to a life that came with no guarantee of her safety or her son's, end quote. Evans reminds us as Christians who, again, are too eagerly skip to the ends of things, that Christmas holds a special moment for us, that there is a need to delay. Yes, we can talk about Easter. Yes, we can talk about the things that Jesus will do, but it's important to remember this moment in time, that Jesus comes to earth as a baby boy. Evans reminds us that this incarnation, this incredible miracle of pregnancy and birth, stand on their own. Again, Evans remarks, quote, "It is nearly impossible to believe that God, shrinking down to the size of a zygote, implanted in the soft lining of a woman's womb, God growing fingers and toes, God kicking and hiccuping." What stands out to me this Christmas season is how God's choice to enter into the world in this manner details the intentionality of Jesus's life, the ongoing story, right, of mangers and nighttime labor and delivery. It reminds us that this incarnation was a deliberate and planned method for revealing to us the nature of God in flesh. And this passage of scripture that we read this morning from John 1 also speaks to this intentionality, to this legacy that Jesus offers us. Again, speaking of Easter at Christmas is not off limits, but when we read the beginning of the Gospel of John, we begin to understand how omnipresent, how present Jesus is and was throughout creation, and how important he is to this world. In the beginning, the very beginning, was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. Jesus was there at the very inception of creation. And like creation itself, Jesus, knit together in Mary's womb, is birthed into the world, given life. Again, breathing and crying, sneezing and nursing, wet and messy, hungry and tired, snuggling against the warmth of his mother's skin. The one who was at the start of creation itself, born of flesh and blood, and yet destined to give those who received him, again from scripture, who believed in his name, power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. That somehow his incarnation helps to speak to our incarnation. His connection to God helps to speak to our inner connection to God. This baby, this child, not only captures the nature of God, but helps us to better understand what it really means to be human. The essence of merging and integrating creation with the Creator. Again, Evans tells of this miracle this way, quote, "To understand Mary's humanity and her central role in Jesus' story is to remind ourselves of this true miracle of incarnation, and that it's the core Christian conviction that God is with us." Emmanuel, God is with us. Plain old ordinary us. Plain old ordinary you and me. God is with us in our fears and in our pain, in our morning sickness and in our ear infections, in our refugee crises and in our endurance of empire, in smelly barns and unimpressive backwater towns, in the labor pains of a new mother and in the cries of a tiny infant. In all these things, God is with us and God is for us. So East Union, community, people of faith, may we not be so impatient this year that we miss the miracle of God with us this Christmas morn. May we celebrate the birth of Jesus as we would of a friend or loved one. Humanity completely revealed, and yet God completely revealed in a small and wonderful new baby. May you celebrate and wonder in awe that God is with us. May it be so.
Let's stand as we are able. O Come All Ye Faithful, 241. Oh.
Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us. oh, more than you could ever know.
Make my wish come true.
To Sean. So I'm going to do something. I want you all to stand as able, and we're rather scattered, so just slowly make your way into the aisle and let's make a group, because we're all going to leave after that anyway. So as you move, we're going to sing Go Tell It on the Mountain 252. And we'll just be our own choir here. Okay, that's good.
That's not really fair. I thought what happened at youth group stayed at youth group. But receive this sending blessing. Today we sing for joy. May you go in celebration, sharing the good news that God has come. Go in peace.